The end of 2.1 is on the horizon. With the official release date of Prelude being announced and the end of 2019 coming, we are all on the edge of our seats to see what creators will make with the new 2.2 mechanics. So I was thinking, what are some of the best things creators have made with the 2.1 editor? With this thought in mind, I compiled a list of my opinion of the best levels of 2.1. I will be showing cut clips of all the levels to make sure the video isn't too long, as we all have a lot of ground to cover. I will also be using other people's gameplay for some of them, and the respective players will be credited in the video and the description. Worry not, I have contacted all the players who own the gameplay and got their consent, and proof of that will be in the description. Because we have so many levels on this list, I will be making this into a three-part series, with 10 levels an episode. For my criteria of how I considered if the level was one of the best, I went off visuals, impact on the community, creativity, and gameplay. Please also keep in mind that this is entirely my opinion and not an objective fact. I tried my hardest to make sure I didn't miss anything. However, since this list spans such a huge time period, it is not unlikely that I will have missed a level or two. If you think something should have been on this list that isn't, please feel free to leave a comment and I will respond. This also goes for if you disagree with the inclusion of a specific level. Also keep in mind that this list is not in any specific order and I am not implying one level is better than another. With all that said, let's just get into the video. First up on the list is one a lot of people probably expected. Released on YouTube as a layout by Prelude on April 2nd, 2018, Baloka is one of the most well-organized mega collabs in GD history. This layout was made by Prelude, as I already said, but the organization and the deco eventually fell to Sminx after Prelude quit the level and it was uploaded on his account. All the parts are very consistent, with a nice mechanical blue and sandy yellow desert theme. The gameplay is extremely well synced and satisfying to watch, and is said to be extremely fun by top players such as Brian the Burger and Gabs. Every part looks great, and some that stand out are Johu's part, Prelude's part, and Sminx's part, though I can't stress enough how every part is nothing short of incredible. The amount of unique ideas and effects this level has, and the way they use it to sync to the music blows my mind. Sminx's part is my favorite, when the sun sets behind the pyramids with the buildup of the drop and the lightning and thunder come out, striking from all angles to the music. Sminx also made the end screen for the level, which is easily one of my favorite end screens ever, on par with Ragnarok's. It has an Austin Indiana Jones font at the end that says Balok very cleanly, and the spinning pyramid and the rotating sun is mind-blowing. I don't even know how that's possible to make. When I first saw this level, I watched it about 5 times over, absolutely in love at first sight. Coupled with epic decoration and awesome song, Balok is one of my personal favorites and one of the best of 2.1 by far. Technically the second Prelude Mega Collab in a row, Freedom 08 was unveiled as a layout on May 3rd, 2017. An instant hit and one of Prelude's self-proclaimed bests, this incredibly fun and well-synced level was decorated, tweaked, extended, and verified throughout the process of 2 whole years. It was finally verified by the extremely determined and skilled player Golden on April 28th, 2019. This level has been critically acclaimed to be fun and well-decorated by huge players such as Technical, Novel Boy, Gizbro, Diamond Splash, and more. Combining the gameplay of the Saint God Prelude and the incredible visuals of an adept team, Freedom 08 is one of the greatest works this game has to offer. In my opinion, it's the best non-Geostorm mega collab and is epic in both visuals and design consistency. Some of the parts that stand out are Prelude's parts of 28, Binox's part, Johu's part, Sminx's part, and Temp's part. This isn't to say that the rest of the level is detracting, as literally every single part in this level is of some of the highest quality this game has ever seen. All the parts in Freedom 08 fit together amazingly, and this is by far one of the best levels ever seen in the Geometry Dash community. Up next is Digital Descent. The standards this level was held to are unimaginable. Being the sequel to the mind-blowing, community-inspiring Artificial Ascent, Digital Descent has the greatest creators of all time behind it. Due to this, the level definitely delivered on the expectations. Every part in this level fits the theme exceptionally in its unmatched in intricacy. Some of the parts that stand out as the best are Kibsu's part, Naz's part, Samifying's part, Abstract Dark's part, the Devon's part, Laser Blitz's part, and Serpunch's part. There's so much good in this level, and it is definitely one of the best Geostorm mega collabs to have been released to date, only topped by levels such as Ouroboros. There's not much else to say about this level other than it keeps the theme pretty well and it has one of my favorite songs ever. Even though this level is excellent, there are still a lot of parts that could be improved, though that is likely a result of how early it was made in 2.1. Still, I think it belongs on this list. Artifice is a decently recent level and you probably have been living under a rock if you haven't seen it yet. From Felix Ramp's controversial verification to all the top players' amends, Artifice has definitely been making its way around the community. This incredible level with an epic song keeps the theme of a quasi-hell level extremely well while adding something fresh to the table. None of the deco is particularly outstanding, but it's all of extreme quality, kind of like Persia. I will say, Rafer and Felix Ramp's parts are without a doubt my favorite though. The syncing gameplay on this level is great, and impact-wise, it has been storming the community. We definitely needed a level like this, and this is easily one of the best of 2.1. Not to mention how this is a hard song to sync in a lot of parts, and the creators nailed it. The end screen is epic also, which is something that happens whenever Anomi gets his fingers on the editor. The only thing I don't like about this level, the only small, very nitpicky thing, is the bone dragon at the end and how it kinda looks awkward because it's so short. If I were to have made it, I would have definitely made it long enough so you can't see the end. That would complete this level for me. That's just a very minuscule thing though, and this level blew my mind when I first saw it. Props to Felix for organizing and keeping the theme consistent of this awesome mega collab. The next level on this list is Delta Interface by Platinu. A very unique level, I would say this is definitely Platinu's best besides his part in Ragnarok and the previews that we've seen of Sigma Interface. Featuring an awesome Camellia song and a blue and orange theme, this level is very tech manifested. It starts out calm and cool with a blue color scheme that picks up when the song starts to move with a flowing custom background that I really like. The sync on this level is excellent, though the gameplay I have heard is not. The custom backgrounds are very simple yet effective, and Platinum's block design is very reminiscent of 1.9 but includes many 2.1 mechanics as well. The drop is awesome, as the level switches to a primarily orange color scheme and takes a very intense feel with an awesome flowing background and big waves that sync very well. The gameplay here is very satisfying to look at, and the drop is actually pretty fun to play from what I've experienced. The level absolutely sells me at the end, as all levels need to end nicely to feel complete. The end screen syncs very well with the music and gives the level a good theme of completion, which is something I like about this level. It feels very well rounded and finished. The decoration might not be top notch, but the way the level feels so polished is not something you often see nowadays. The only thing I don't like about this level that stands out to me is the big empty spaces that Platinum could have done so much with at the slow ship at 27%, but it took me a while to notice that it wasn't even empty, so I think it's okay like it is. Overall, Delta Interface is a very unique level and one of the best of 2.1 because of its special qualities of well-roundedness and consistent decoration. Next up is Zolas. Zolas is insane. The second in a series of movie-like levels, the creator Sputniks used a program to create the crazy 3D effects used in this level. The way that these visuals actually look real and how they actually look like something you'd see in real life, just very pixelated, is just insane to me. The entire level is made out of circles, which gives it a very shimmery effect. The only problems with this level is that it has a very heavy object count, and it is hard to conceive what is actually being displayed in some images because of the limitations of the editor. There are some scenes where you can actually depict what's being shown, like one scene with the sun setting in a city, one with an eye, one with a light bulb, and one final one where you see Sputniks filming his very own computer on the geometry dash screen. This very, very unique level is definitely pushing the limits of 2.1, and I am excited to see what Sputniks can do with 2.2. Definitely one of the best levels of 2.1. Up next is Distraught by Alkali and More. Distraught is an epic level, and the song works very well with the atmosphere of the decoration. They complement each other very well, and I love the way this level uses an overall gray theme but has splashes of color that sync to the music. It's something I've never really seen before, and I'm a huge fan of it. That's just something this level does very well, syncing the music with the deco. It's not just pulses in the background, it's gears spinning, ground moving, and effects all pulsing to the music. Juho and Yakko's parts do this especially well, and as a result, the level as a whole builds an extremely immersive experience. This, coupled with the amazing soundscape that the song lays, provides an excellent level that has you on the edge of your seat right until the final click. Up next is Catalyzed by Zephyriox. I love this level so much. The way Zephyrox uses glow so masterfully blows my mind. Every time I watch a replay of this, I pause it at some parts and see some awesome intricacy that I never noticed before. Zeph does such a great job of recreating Darwin's style in Zephakil but making it his own and polishing all the rough edges. This is easily one of the best of 2.1, no doubt. The way he uses Darwin's style in his own at 55% is awesome. I could go on about this level for days, but I'll spare you the details and move on to the next level. Up next is WoW by Trustin Moore. This level is sick. That's the best word for it. It's not epic like something like Ouroboros, Distraught, or the Eschaton. It's just sick. The song is sick, the deco is sick, the gameplay is sick, the sync is sick. WoW was supposed to be Trusta's last verification, being his extreme demon spam mega collab, but it eventually failed in a Pesta to verify. Utilizing a few creators to make it a very small mega collab, WoW keeps a very consistent quality that makes it that much more special. All the parts are excellent, but Chase 97's, Panuto's, Failure's, and Marwek's parts are standout design-wise. The full gameplay was revealed by Trusta on September 16th, 2019, and the layout had me so hyped. I remember going through the wormhole of YouTube one time in mid-2018 and finding the layout again and thinking how the level was never gonna get finished. Guess I was wrong. All the parts in this level are awesome, but don't even get me started in 45%. The flow, the drop, all I can say is thank you for organizing this, Trusta. Definitely one of the best levels in 2.1. Up next is Idols by Zephakil, GD, and more. Decoration-wise, I wouldn't say this is one of the best, but if you factor in the theming, I would say this is definitely one. Idols is a level that is a nod back to the good old days of Geometry Dash, with parts that are themed to the older decoration and parts that feature gameplay and deco styled to old legendary levels, such as Theory of Skrillex, Nine Circles, Windy Landscape, Death Moon, and more. This level does a great job of adapting all those old decoration styles to fit into the new 2.1 style that the majority of the level is in. When it comes to raw deco with filler parts, some of the parts are good and some are bad. The main focus is the nostalgia though. It makes me happy every time I watch this and can look back on how far the community has come. Overall, this level is a good piece of nostalgia and I wanted to include it on this list because of the feelings it evokes. For these reasons, I would say it's one of the best of 2.1. Come now. I want to end the video by thanking three people. Firstly, my friends Nadia and CAPTAINCLUMSY for helping me with this video. Their channels will be linked in the description and they're great people, so you should definitely check them out. Secondly, you. Thank you so much for watching this, as it means the world to me. If you really enjoyed it, then you're in luck. As I said at the beginning, this will be a three-part series. Part 2 might take a while to come out as I have a lot of schoolwork, but subscribe to stay posted on its release. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed as I put a lot of effort into this. Have a nice day.